Hey everyone, today I would like to talk to you about my media rights collection from Guerlain. Guerlain is one of my favorite fragrance houses and it's one of my favorite makers of makeup. I love Guerlain makeup. It's usually understated, very elegant, high quality, and they put really a lot of effort into their formulations most of the time. Their limited edition stuff, I would say, is of a lesser interest to me most of the time, with an exception of the meteorites. Meteorites are something I've been collecting for years and years, I've been using for many years and used up multiple boxes of, and some of them are safely stored in my parents' basement because I do like to collect even the empty boxes because they're just so beautiful and look so vintage. Let's start with the permanent collection. So what are meteorites? Meteorites are tiny little balls of powder that you use. It's a finishing powder. They come in different colors. Some of them are more color correcting. Some of them are more illuminating. Some of them are slightly more bronzing for pale girls like myself. I would say that unfortunately darker skin tones will not get as much benefit from the meteorite powders because usually they're sort of formulated with a very light skin tone in mind, maybe light to medium. It's unfortunate. I wish that they had a bigger selection and perhaps kept in mind women of color as well. However, for me, for my skin tone, it works really, really well. It does give most of the time slightly illuminated, very beautiful finish to the skin. For most people, it'll be a finishing powder, but if, like myself, you have dry skin type, it could really work for you as a setting powder as well. So for me, it looks quite natural on my skin as a setting powder. I skip the setting powder. I just use this meteorites and it lasts very well on me. So let's start with the permanent collection. I have two colors from the permanent collection. First one is number one, Blanc de Perles. I've used up this bottle previously. This is my winter shade for meteorites. You see the beautiful box. Of course, the gorgeousness of the box cannot be underestimated. It's all about the packaging. The packaging is beautiful. Let's look inside and we see a very, very pale girl's dream. This is a very white powder with some color correcting elements. We see blue, lavender, and yellow with lots and lots of white pearls. So this is quite brightening even on a very light skin tone. It works for pale people like myself, and I would recommend if you are very pale and have trouble finding something that doesn't look powdery, for you to try the meteorites. Just test them out in a boutique and see if there is something that could interest you, because they are very, very nice on the skin. And another box is Tombe Beige 02. So same permanent line, and this is this color number 2. They have, I think, a total of only 3 colors, and the second one is my skin tone for the summer. That's what I use during maybe late spring, summer months. And here you see also some color correcting pearls, like you have the lavender and the pink, and lots of beigey gold pearls as well, which will sort of not bronze up the skin. They don't have this much pigment, but they will give your skin a little bit of a sort of golden glow. So for the summertime, these are my pearls. Now I have a limited edition highlighter from the meteorites range, and that came out, I believe, in Asia at some point. I'm not even sure if it was ever available in North America, but I did buy it because, you know, I'm crazy. So this is meteorites in 00 Blanc de Perles. So very white. And in fact, it's a fantastic highlight for very, very pale skin. There's going to be a lot of kick up with that one. These are the 00 Blanc de Perles. They're white, they're pearly, really, and quite easy to wear. You see there's a little bit of a pink sheen on, you won't be able to see, but there's a little bit of a pink sheen, duochrome pink sheen on some of the pearls. They're beautiful. It's a gorgeous highlight. It's very, very flattering for very pale skin tones. I think anybody with a medium skin tone will find it a little bit too light. But for pale girls, it's a really, really good find. Now to the limited edition stuff. Let's start with Christmas 2012-2013. This is the beauty that came that year for Christmas. It's 52 grams of product. It's called Perles de Paradis, Paradise Pearls. This is beautiful packaging. This is one of the few times that they did cardboard packaging, and I didn't mind because this is actually very high quality. You see the blush pink with the Guerlain emblem, and it's just a really, really beautiful packaging. And here you see engravement even that that box held up very well because I've had it since 2013. So let's look inside. Unfortunately, this is the only meteorites that had crushed. I've had them kind of fall apart on me because I really banked them around a lot. I traveled with them quite a bit. Comes with a powder puff, and you can see and appreciate the color of the powder. You see the lavender tones of it. This is the powder, what it looks like now, because it's been kind of crushed. Unfortunately, no pearls to see anymore, but I still use the powder because the powder is lovely. It does a very good job at brightening up the skin. The lavender tones work super well with pale skin and sort of give you an awakened, more luminous look to the skin. So this one is actually very lovely and I'm very happy to have it. Next is Christmas 2013-2014. And these are from the Champs-Élysées Crazy Pearls collection. You see the name of the collection sort of in a very cartoony way portrayed on the bottle, on the box. The box is fun. It's very pop art to me. I like it, but it's one of my least favorite, I think, boxes that they've come up with. This one is metal, like most of them. There are only a couple that I have that are plastic or cardboard. So, very normal metal box. And here we can see that these are quite color correcting and sort of reminiscent of the permanent collection beige, but with a little bit more color correction. So you see the beige tones, a bit of a golden sheen to many of the pearls. You see the lavender and a bit of a pink tone as well. For me, this was a little bit too pink, so I pulled a few pink pearls from here and put them in my meteorites blush. So that worked out really well, and now I can enjoy this. This is, I would say, sort of similar to the 02 beige from the permanent collection. I use them interchangeably. It's not a huge difference. Next one is Christmas 2014-2015. And you see, this was inspired, I believe, by the opera. They came up with a really nice perfume in the same collection that I don't actually own. And the pearls themselves are called Perles d'Étoiles. So pearls, starry pearls. This box is really nice. It's very gold with a red accent. Inside you see that the interior of the box is also the same red with a red powder puff with a red satin bow. And the pearls in this one are gorgeous. They're so golden bronze. You see a bit of beige, you see some very pale pink ones, but really they're very golden. And they're beautiful on the skin. I really like them because they really liven up the skin tone, especially my pale skin tone. They sort of not bronze it up, but just bring a little bit more life into it because there is a slight pigment that will brighten it up if you have, like, you know, the really white canvas like myself, so it has a chance to show up. I love these in the summer. I love these in the winter. I think they work year-round. It's the goldest box I have. Next one is Summer 2015 edition, and these are rainbow pearls. Now, these are very, very color correcting. They came up with the wonderful white and gold box, sort of pastel colors here, very standard metal box. And let's see inside. You have the blush pink puff, the blush pink interior, and very color correcting pearls. So if we check it out, we have some white, some beige, some sort of Tiffany blue, some pink, and some salmon colored pearls. These are very nice and they do deliver a certain amount of color correction. This is not crazy pigmented sort of product, and it's not a product that will do your color correction for you. Just if you're using it as a setting powder, it'll ever so slightly color correct and brighten, which I really, really like. So these, I would say, kind of tone-wise lie between the permanent collection, the really light ones, the color 01, and the 02 beige ones. This is kind of in between in terms of the tone, and I think very, very versatile, easy to use. Next one is the gorgeous plastic packaging. This is Christmas 2015-2016. Okay, this looks like it's an ornament from the Christmas tree. They're called Poudre Sublimatrice Flocon Enchanté. Flocon Enchanté. This collection, I think, was called De Neige. And I have two products from there. So this is number one. What a beautiful, beautiful packaging. Crazy pretty. When we open this gold and white ball, we actually have a mirror that is new. Guerlain doesn't really do mirrors in their meteorites usually. And we have the white powder puff and the standard shape of a satin bow, but this time it's golden, kind of chartreuse actually. So when we see inside, it's kind of a bit of a highlight that can be used as a setting powder for winter months for me. So you see there's a tiny cute little star, there are beige and gold pearls with some white ones. These are actually surprisingly wearable. I don't think that they're for parties or glittery or anything like that. I think for everyday use you can use this very, very easily. I really like these. These are also very versatile. Next, Christmas 2015-2016 product is this meteorite's Perle de Blush called Angelic Radiance Pearls. This was so disappointing in terms of packaging. It's pretty cheaply made cardboard packaging. Very sad that this happened. I think the product itself is wonderful, but the packaging is disappointing, and I think Guerlain should be ashamed of themselves because they charge an arm and a leg for their products. So, you know, they really should deliver beautiful product and beautiful packaging. I don't see why they would do this. I mean, it's already getting dirty. I haven't been using it all that much, and it's already kind of getting a little gross. But let's look inside. Here we have the puff, and here we have actually a very pretty pink blush that I do enjoy wearing very, very much. It's bright, it's pink, it's really, really pretty. The blush is not ultra pigmented, but it's pigmented enough for maybe light to medium skin tones, maybe even darker skin tones could wear this because it's such a bright color. I think it's quite flattering and quite universal, one of the more universal products that Guerlain had released. Unfortunately, they are not very dark skin friendly most of the time. Next one is something that I use as a blush, actually. And this is a spring-summer 2016 release, and it's called Perle Carousel. So Carousel Pearls. First of all, the box I love. Look at this sort of candy, sort of a funfair candy pink box with pastel accents and white. Oh, it's so pretty. I really, really like this packaging. I think this is one of the better boxes that they've released. It looks very vintage and adorable. It looks like a fanfare. I can see where the carousel is coming from. Inside it's white, and the balls, the little pearls themselves, are very multicolored and quite bright, actually. So there are plenty of pink and lavender tones in here, some yellow corrective ones, and a whole bunch of white tiny pearls. Now, this I love using as a blush. For my pale complexion, this actually works as a blush. The pink pearls are pigmented enough to make it a blush. Very, very subtle, but I do like that look. I do like that effect, and I'm really happy to have this. First of all, the packaging is adorable, and second of all, it's kind of multitasking. I can wear it actually as a setting powder, but I really prefer it as a blush with a little bit more product. The last limited edition meteorites that I have to show you here is this one. It's meteorites Perle de Légende, Legendary Pearls. This is this year's Christmas collection, Shalimar collection. Super, super beautiful. You can see this rich, shiny blue and gold combination. Looks fantastic. I think very nice job on the packaging. I bought a few items from that collection. It was a very good collection. And the colors are very wearable, actually, in the pearls. And this is a quite a wearable one. So you can see there is a bit of color correcting Tiffany blue. You have the pink, and you have tons of gold and tiny little shimmery pearls. This is somewhat of a mix between a color correcting powder and the golden one that was this one. So it's like they kind of mushed the two ideas together, and it's quite refreshing. It looks very nice on the skin. The gold brightens and sort of gives your face a little bit of a luminosity. The pink brightens it up and gives it a bit of life. And the Tiffany blue does a little bit of color correcting, but they're not super pigmented, the blue ones, so you're not going to get blue blotches on your face. So really, really beautiful. Now for the travel meteorites that I have. First of all, I have one of these tiny ones that are sold in airports, and they're sold in a couple as a double. So there's this pink one and there is a white one. The white one I finished up, and now the box I think is resting in my parents' basement as a collectible item. Whenever we move into our house, I'm gonna take it and probably put it in display because it's just so adorable. Look at how cute it is. This is one of the cardboard boxes as well, but it's sturdy enough. It's actually much better quality than this blush thing. Weird. Again, Guerlain, don't do that to me again. I will be upset with you. So here we have the 01, the very first lightest one, and I do travel with that. Like I said, I finished a tiny one before, the white one. And the next travel palette I have is this one. Also, you might have seen it sort of, you might have seen it in an airport before. It's this blush pink palette, and it's called Meteorites My Palette. I do admit that it's quite good for traveling, but it looks a bit cheap inside, I would say. So here you have a mirror, and you have a brush. The brush is actually the same exact bristles as the Meteorites brush that they sell. And you have three products here. You have the pressed meteorites. You have the highlight that is quite nice and pearly, very reminiscent of the 00 pearls that I showed you, Perle de Blanc. And we have a nice pink blush that is very versatile and is reminiscent of this blush that is the Éclat Angélique Angelic Radiance. So quite a nice little trio, actually. Like I said, it looks a little bit cheap inside, I would say. On the outside, it's a little bit cheap as well, actually. But the products are so good that I keep traveling with that palette, and actually I'm getting good use out of it. So regardless of the packaging that I'm not in love with. Yes, I'm not a big fan of the packaging, but I think it's a really, really nice find, actually, and a good palette to travel with. Now we'll come to the compacts. The compacts are stars, definitely, for the meteorite range. First one is this limited edition. I believe it's a limited edition one, but I'm not entirely sure. This one is a mattifying illuminating powder, Voyage Enchanté. First of all, let's discuss the packaging. This is really, really heavy. It's a really heavy powder compact, and inside you have a refills that can be replaced once you run out. This is designed to last you a lifetime. You can have one of these for the rest of your life and it'll hold up and won't fall apart on you. It's extremely good quality. It's very heavy, and it's certainly a luxe product. I actually have not seen a compact that was more luxe than this one. You have the enameled detail here. You have really, really nice craftsmanship. You have a really, really beautifully made compact, for sure. Hands down, I have not seen a nicer compact anywhere. Please let me know if you have, because I want to know. And here, this is the mattifying powder. Again, very good for very light-skinned people. It's basically translucent, but slight white cast is there. So I wouldn't recommend it if you have dark skin tone, because I think it'll make you look ashy. Next one is this little guy. And this little guy is actually the permanent color in 01 Mythic. This is their regular Meteorite Voyage or Voyage Meteorites. I'm not entirely sure if this is the regular packaging. I think so. This blush pink enameled top, very heavy again, very beautiful, very sleek, gorgeous, just something you can pass on to your granddaughter kind of thing, you know, very, very pretty. Here we have the sectorial breakdown of different color correcting colors, and you can see how they would work. kind of mixed together to create a pretty universal color. I think this would be better than the mattifying one for different skin tones, but still might make you look ashy. Just, you know, warning. This one was a lovely gift from my husband, and this is a newer sort of limited edition compact. Again, quite heavy. It's about the same amount of heaviness, the same weight, maybe a little bit lighter than the original. It's a little bit of a different shape. This one looks like it has sort of a pearly or maybe a ivory look to it. It's quite nice. This is plastic, but it looks like a pearlescent mother of pearl. There is a certain sheen to it, but I believe it's plastic, of course. Quite heavy, quite nice, very luxe looking powder. And you see that this one has a slightly different pattern. It doesn't have these mosaic sections, but rather sort of a speckled look to it. Again, very, very beautiful. Of course, you cannot fault Guerlain's packaging. Most of the time, they know what they're doing with it. The last one I want to show you is this one. And this one is actually the one I travel with, actually. Those other ones I do travel with occasionally, but mostly I take this one. Why? Because this is a less luxurious, less complex, and much lighter version of Meteorites. But this is not Voyage. I think it's really a version of the pressed version of the normal Meteorites. You get significantly less product. Right now you're getting 25 grams in each of the Meteorite boxes, but here you get only 10 grams of product. That's it. That's really not very much. The packaging is significantly less luxe than the Voyage Meteorite compacts, and it's much lighter. You cannot replace the refill. You cannot refill this one, so once it's done, it's done. And good riddance too, because it's not going to hold up like the other ones. Here you have also this mosaic sort of look to the compact, and to be honest, it looks exactly like the Meteorites. I have it in two clair, which corresponds with one blanc de perle. So it's the lightest one they carry, I believe. That's it for my Meteorites collection. I hope you had fun with it, and maybe you saw something you liked and would look it up online at some point. I encourage you to check out the Meteorite collections that consistently come out from Guerlain at least once a year. They'll have a Meteorites compact, or check out the Permanent collection, which is also very, very good and very versatile, unless, of course, you're quite dark-skinned, and then you might run into problems, you might not, I don't know, you need to try. So this is it for Guerlain's Meteorites and my collection. Have a good day. See you later. Bye-bye.